Dome in downtown Atlanta. And this is the National Football League on CBS. Week 7, we've got a good one for you as the Bengals take on the Falcons. Today's game is brought to you in Sony High Definition. Time now for the Superstar Spotlight. Two future Hall of Famers take the field in his 14th year. Tony Gonzalez is a pass-catching machine who will go down as maybe the greatest tight end of all time. And then there's T.O., brash, bold, and one of the most electric players to ever step on the field. Today, these two Canton-bound receivers gear up for a major showdown in Atlanta.
CBS Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Bengals and Falcons ready to get busy. Atlanta won the toss. They've elected to receive. Marvin Lewis's team coming off the bye. Prior to that, a 24-21 loss to Tampa Bay. Meanwhile, Mike Smith, affectionately known around here as Smitty, his team losing 31-17 at Philly last week. 12th overall meeting between these two teams. Bengals lead the series 7-4. Last meeting in 0-2. Atlanta won it 30-3. That year, the Bengals were 2-14 under Dick LeBeau, Chad Ochocinco's second season. So back deep, Eric Reams ready to return. Mike Nugent sends it away, and we're underway from the Georgia Dome. Here's Reams inside his own 5. And he tries to get outside and is wrapped up and taken down. Nice draft tackle by Morgan Trent, and it's a return. 14 yards. So Matt Ryan, last week against the Eagles, 23-42, 250 yards. He was sacked 3 times, completed 54.8% of his pass attempts, the lowest percentage of the season.
Yeah, and look for him to get back on track. He is money in this building, Gus. This team becomes really tough to beat when the Falcons play at home.
First down and 10 at the 17-yard line. Mahalian Turner in the backfield. Ryan throwing on first down, steps up into the pocket, fires, finds Turner out of the backfield. Tries to get outside, stop. Stays on his feet, finally wrestled out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Dahani Jones with the tackle, a gain of 4. Time now to take a look at the starting lineup for the Atlanta Falcons.
Well, up front for the Atlanta Falcons, Sam Baker, the left tackle. He's a 3-year starter. He started as much as Matt Ryan, the guy he protects. They've been together since day one. Then you go to the backs and receivers, Roddy White. We spoke about him in the open, Gus. This is a guy that people around the NFL are going to start talking about, and he is probably the best receiver in this game today.
Second down and 6 at the 21, and they hand it off straight ahead. Former San Diego Charger. And he is wrestled down after a gain of 3 yards. Defensively for the Cincinnati Bengals, let's take a look.
Yeah, and you look at Tank Johnson down inside, told his teammates, was very vocal about getting on track during that bye week. Everybody's got to look at themselves in there and do their job. And then, of course, in the linebacking core, Ray Maualuga told us everything's in place in this team, but it's just not clicking. This same team that swept their division last year, and Adam Jones gets the start today in place of Jonathan Joseph, who's out with an ankle.
Adam, no longer call me Pac-Man. Jones, third down and 3 of the 24. Ryan underneath, and he's got his receiver, Ronnie White, down the sideline, and he's out of bounds. Deep inside Bengal territory, Leon Hall pushed him out, but it's a gain of 46.
Well, all you can say about this play, Gus, is we told you. I mean, the guy is great. On a down, when you know they're going to drop back and throw it, their best receiver comes wide open crossing the middle, and you see how he is with the ball in his hands. I mean, they're just, Leon Hall's trying to catch him, and Roddy White's just too big and physical.
Roddy White, 29th catch for a first down this year, most in the NFC, third in the NFL behind Reggie Wayne and Brandon Lloyd. First down and 10 at the 30. Jason Snelling checks into the backfield, and they hand it off. Snelling running to the left, and he's tracked down immediately. Keith Rivers with the tackle. In his third year out of South Carolina, USC rather, and it's a loss of 2.
You know, Gus, let's talk a little bit about Roddy White. I mean, well, that says it all. He's ranked first in the conference in every real category that receivers look at. I mean, they look at him 70 times. Nobody looks at another guy more than they look at him. He's got the most first down receptions. I mean, the guy is really, really good, and teams know it when they come in there, and yet can't stop him.
Last week, 6 catches, 83 yards. Second and 12, underneath. Oh, look at him. Go up and bring that football down across the middle. All hands, gain of 18 for White.
Well, he just runs a thin post at the top, and this is a timing route. You'll watch. He's just going to snap his head around. Ball's already in the air, and he goes up and grabs it. That ball couldn't have been thrown any better. The route couldn't have been run any better, and the catch speaks for itself.
First down and 10, opening drive for Atlanta at the Bengal 14-yard line. Mahaley and Turner in the backfield. White, 2 catches, 64 yards already. Here's Turner. Lowers his shoulder, and Turner gets to the 7. That's a 7-yard gain. Crocker with the tackle.
Well, there you have it. I mean, Michael Turner is a great compliment. Most of the teams in the league who have these great offenses have three things, Gus: a running back like Mike Turner, a quarterback like Matt Ryan, and a guy like Roddy White. And you get this offensive line. You see Tony Gonzalez, great block at the point of attack to get him around the backside. Well, that's a great offensive play on first down.
Second down at 3 at the 7-yard line. And some movement up front. Looks like the Bengals may have jumped across the line. But we'll see. There's a flag on the play.
Offside, number 99. Defense. The 5-yard penalty will result in the first down.
You know, this is the thing that has been so frustrating for the Cincinnati Bengals. They have just absolutely gotten too many penalties. And the penalties like that are crushers because you don't even get a chance to compete on that play. The play doesn't count. It stops it before it gets started, and it costs you 5 yards and gives your opponents a first down inside your 5-yard line. It's inexcusable.
First down and goal at the 3-yard line. Ryan out of the shotgun, and he hands it off to Snelling. And Snelling, no gain on the play. Robert gathers with the tackle for the Bengals.
Just watch this play takes place. Try to get a trap block up inside, and Domina Pekka just blows it up. Gets too much penetration from his defensive tackle spot. Mike Smith wondering what's going to happen next in this first and goal or second and goal situation. Atlanta looks so tough here in the early going.
At the 3-yard line. And Ryan in the shotgun. 8th play of the drive that started at the Atlanta 17. Ryan looking in the end zone. Touchdown. Fitter. Matt Ryan throws a strike to Brian Fitter. The 10th year man out of Villanova. And Atlanta goes up 6-0. A 3-yard score.
That was an impressive drive by Atlanta. You'll watch Ryan look right to the back of the end zone. Threads the needle. This whole drive set up by Roddy White's 46-yard reception.
Extra point good. Matt Ryan on the drive. 4 of 4. 71 yards. And he throws the touchdown to Veteran. So the Atlanta Falcons strike first blood. 7-0 over the Bengals. Brian Finneran with his second touchdown of the year, and Atlanta takes a 7-0 lead. So the Bengals ready to receive it. Back deep, Scott and Cosby. And this will be Scott from the 5. And Scott with a very nice return. Bernard Scott picks up 25. Stopped by Spencer Atkins, and here comes Carson Palmer. He'll have to respond on the road. Beautiful sunny day here in Atlanta. Temperature in the 70s outside, inside. Here come the Bengals on offense, ranked 11th in the NFL, 7th in passing, 18th in rushing. On first down, Carson Palmer to the sideline. And that's Ochocinco with the catch at the 35. So last week, Carson Palmer, 21 of 36, 209 yards in that loss to Tampa Bay. It was his first three-interception game since November 18th of 2007 when he threw four picks against Arizona. Second down and four at the 35. Cedric Benson, the lone setback. They give it to Benson over the right side, and he is hit in the backfield. First man to him, Jonathan Babineau, and it's a two-yard gain. Let's take a look at the Cincinnati Bengals offense.
Well, on the offensive line, Andre Smith, the first-round draft pick out of Alabama a year ago, gets the start at right tackle, and if you're looking at their offense, one guy you might not know about is rookie Jermaine Gresham, the rookie. He may set the rookie receiving record. He's got 22 so far this year. The record 67 set by Chris Collinsworth in 1981.
Third down and two at the 37 for the Bengals. Falcon fans really getting into it now. Here's Palmer out of the shotgun. Over to the sideline. Ochocinco again. And he's knocked out of bounds by Christopher Owens. And that's a 10-yard gain and a first down for the Bengals.
Yeah, he's going to come out and run the deep out. Watch how he's going to make him think he's going to go deep and then just snaps it off to the outside. The ball's already in the air. They had underneath coverage by the linebacker dropping out. And you see, just throws it over the top and underneath the corner for the reception.
First down at the 47. Here's Benson running the football. And he picks up a couple. Jamal Anderson with the tackle. Let's take a look at this Atlanta Falcons D of 4-3.
Yeah, well, it starts out up front. John Abraham, the pass rusher. Cincinnati's very worried about getting him, keeping him contained. He's in much better shape this year. And then in the back end, Curtis Lofton. He's good height, good college friends with Jermaine Gresham, the rookie tight end. Looking forward to seeing him in the back end. Chris Owens gets the start because of Dante Robinson's injury.
Carson Palmer throwing, and he finds T.O. Terrell Owens brought down by Brent Grimes, gains 5 yards. So on the opening drive for Cincinnati, Steve, they're having some success as Carson Palmer spreads the football around.
Yeah, and they're also going no huddle. Right now they'll huddle up really for the first time, and it's really given them a chance to isolate Owens and Ochocinco on the outside and get them spread around, move around, make it tough for the defense to find itself and get the calls made to adjust to their motion and their formations. It's really all an effort to get the ball to those outside two receivers.
Third down and three at the 46. Empty backfield for Palmer on the shotgun. And he fires, deflected in a fly. Intended for Ochocinco. Williams and Owens covering for Atlanta. Riverson is your referee today.
There is no foul on the play. It was an unbalanced formation. It will be fourth down.
Yeah. They had an unbalanced formation, and the officials wanted to make sure that the alignment on the far side had the proper number of guys on the line of scrimmage. Ochocinco trying to run the little juke route where he comes in, fakes like he's going to cross the field, and then sticks it and goes back outside. Carson Palmer, trusting that he's going to be there, almost got it picked off by Owens.
So Kevin Huber will punt it from the 39. End over end. Kick, and it's fielded inside the 10 by Eric Weems. A 37-yard punt. 7-0 Atlanta with the lead and the ball when we come back. That's Dante Robinson, and he is in the center of a big week in the National Football League.
Yeah, he's not playing today because of an injury he suffered last week. As we take you back to a week ago and remind you all of what happened, there's the hit, another hit by James Harrison, the Pittsburgh game, another hit there. And then, of course, the one here that the Falcons fans saw, Dante Robinson. Not only did DeSean Jackson leave the game injured, Dante Robinson injured himself on that play. That has led to a huge controversy around the league about what it's going to be like for defenders tackling guys.
First down and 10 at the 9-yard line, Michael Turner. And Turner gang tackled after a 1-yard play. Frosty Rucker, first man to him. let's keep talking about what's been going on in the NFL as you take a look at the response from the league.
Well, yeah, and this is it. I mean, there's going to right on the first offense, it doesn't get any two strikes and you're out. It happens right away. And the coaches and the club will be held responsible as well. And, of course, the officials have been directed to emphasize and be very sensitive to big hits happening on the football field.
Second down and 9 to the 10. Ryan with time pulls it down. To run, has good wheels, and slides down to the 20. Looks like he has the first down, but there's a flag on the play.
Yeah, Matt Ryan's going to drop back. The pocket's going to collapse around him, and he's going to break loose. And this is going to be a hold as it comes back. But Ryan does the exact right thing, and that's really a crusher for a defense, Gus. They've got so many weapons. The one you really don't account for is the quarterback breaking contain and running, particularly a drop-back quarterback like Matt Ryan. Other quarterbacks may be known for that. He's not. So when he does it in a way like that, it's completely unexpected, and it really hurts a defense. But now this one got called back.
So that brings up second and 14 from the 5-yard line. Ryan in the gun, standing right on the goal line. Michael Jenkins lines up in the slot at the bottom of your screen. Ryan underneath finds Jenkins at the 10-yard line, and he gets hit quickly. Jones and Ndukwe starting for Roy Williams at safety today. It's a gain of 6.
And what we've just been talking about, you wonder, as you see Jenkins come off the ball, he'll catch this and watch where the defenders tackle him. Low and very high. And that's a big hit, but he was not defenseless. Michael Jenkins had a chance to catch the ball, tuck it, and flex and be ready for the hit before the contact came.
Third down and 8. Here's Ryan over the middle. Snelling, and he's tripped up. Beautiful tackle by Damani Jones, the 11-year veteran out of Michigan. And that will make this Cincinnati Bengals team get a little bit more fired up going off the field as they shut out Atlanta on that series.
And Atlanta can look at themselves and say, we lost that with a holding penalty on second down. That really hurt us. But you'll see Matt Ryan probably is going to have a chance to run. When you see a quarterback do that early in the game, it reminds them, and sometimes they come back to it later in the game.
Michael Kaden punts it away. Adam Jones back deep. Here's Jones from the 34. Jones stumbles and gets to the 40. A 53-yard punt, a 5-yard return. And here comes T.O. Great field position for the Bengals on offense. First down and 10 to the 40-yard line for the Bengals. Trailing 7-0. Cedric Benson in the backfield. They give it to Benson. And Benson crosses the 40. Gains 3 yards. Mike Peterson, Chauncey Davis with the tackle. Let's take a look at this Atlanta D this season entering week 7.
Yeah, first quarter they're really struggling giving up points more so than anybody else in the league. And you look, these other teams down here are the ones really struggling. Atlanta, one of the teams that really is in contention the whole way, is overcoming a slow start to most of their games.
Second down at 7 at the 43. Benson again, this time with a lot of running room. And Benson picks up 11 yards on the play as he's tackled by Deku. Cedric Benson has a solid running back for this Cincinnati team. He averaged 96 yards per game last season, second most in the NFL, ranks 9th in the league this year, averaging 81 yards per game. And his season high of 144 yards came in the Bengals' last game against Tampa Bay. First down and 10 at the 46. Palmer steps up in the pocket. Down the sideline, T.O. Incomplete.
Gus, you had to figure
this is covering on the play.
Excuse me, Gus. You had to figure that the Bengals were going to try and take a shot. The thing that has killed the Atlanta Falcons all year has been big plays. You see Owens trying to go on the out route to get the other Owens to try and bite on that out route. He didn't do it, stayed disciplined, and defended the big play.
Second and 10 at the 46. Benson again. Benson beautiful juke to get north and south. It gains 8 yards. Brian Williams brings him down, and the Bengals are trying to quickly get to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Deku, and this is what we've been talking about, guys. You see, Deku came in and hit Cedric Benson right at the top and hit his head, and now Deku doesn't really know where he is. And you can see shaking his head. He had to take a knee. He got up, but he was not himself, and his teammates immediately knew it. They looked at him, and as he's trying to shrug his shoulders and shake it off, believe me, Thomas Deku is in some duress.
What are they asking him right now, Steve?
Can you read the scoreboard? You watch what happened. Listen to this hit. That's a big hit. And the reason there's no penalty there is because Cedric Benson is protecting himself. He's not defenseless, and that's why that big hit was not penalized.
Third down and 2 at the 38. Bengals 1 of 2 on third down conversion so far in the first quarter. Cedric Benson, the lone setback. Here's Benson with running room again. Picks up the first down. Breaks tackles. Oh, smash mouth running by Benson. As he picks up 9 on third down and 2, Brian Williams finally got him by the ankle.
Well, you think about what this secondary for Atlanta is going through right now. When Benson gets into the back, there you see that's William Moore going in and getting bounced backwards. And then, of course, everybody rallies. Brian Williams comes in, finally tries to shoestring Cedric Benson to the ground. But with Dante Robinson already out, and, of course, we just saw Deku go out. It's just 2 less guys they have in that secondary.
First down and 10. Palmer throwing in the end zone. Incomplete. A flag on the play. Ball intended for Jordan Shipley, the rookie out of Texas. And Christopher Owens was covering.
Wow, this looked... I didn't see the contact that would have... That would have meant the... You can see, you read their lips.
Pass interference.
21.
Number 21.
And
defense. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
I did not see that penalty. Maybe it'll show up at the end. Palmer dropping straight. Looks to his right. Then pump fakes and then comes back. Oh, he got there early. He came up. He was playing the ball, but he went through Shipley to get to the ball. And he got there too early, and that's the penalty, and it was a good call.
A 26-yard penalty. First and goal at the 3. Cedric Benson, he's been running well. This time, they catch him in the backfield. Nice job, Chauncey Davis. 6th-year player out of Florida State, a loss of 1.
Yeah, and this is where the success they've had up to this point of the drive, they thought they might be able to continue it, but the Atlanta Falcons answer with extra defensive linemen. They go heavy down front in with Chauncey Davis. Put him into the lineup. They've just got too many heavy bodies to run between the tackles for the Bengals.
2nd down and goal at the 4. As you take a look at how Cincinnati has fared inside the red zone. 6 touchdowns. Play clock winding down. They get it off. Benson. And Benson is stopped by Eric Coleman, and that's a 2-yard gain. So it may be difficult for Cincinnati to score in the red zone. The Bengals are tied for 27th in the red zone in red zone offense this season, while the Falcons defense ranks 4th in the league.
That's right, and that's the one reason is it's tough to run on Atlanta down close. Cincinnati tried to pack it in and punch it in physically. Then they spread out the Atlanta defense and tried to run it in that way. Now we'll see if they spread it out and try and throw it.
3rd down and goal of the 2, 8th play of the drive that started at the 40. Cedric Pierman checks in. Palmer in the gun. Goes in the end zone. Incomplete. Intended for Terrell Owens. That ball thrown high. And the Bengals will have to settle for a field goal.
Well, they tried it 3 different ways. Like I said, they packed it in there, went heavy, and tried a short yardage play. Then they spread it out. You see Chad Ocho Cinco trying to help Terrell Owens get up and get that ball, and he just couldn't jump up. Had too much electricity in that pass for Owens to gather himself and get enough height on his jump.
Brings on Mike Nugent, 12 of 13 this season. Into attempt a 20-yard field goal. Gets it up. And good. So Cincinnati gets on the board. 22 seconds to play in the first quarter. 7-3 game here in Atlanta. You can build your own football dynasty and compete year-round with CBSSports.com. Franchise football. Find out more at CBSSports.com/franchise. Gus Johnson, Steve Tasker with you from the Georgia Dome. Cedric Benson running the football well. 35 yards rushing so far for Benson as Cincinnati goes 9 plays, 58 yards. Nugent with a 20-yard field goal.
And he put a hurting on Atlanta's defense with those runs he made on that drive. That was a statement drive right there, letting Atlanta know it was not going to be as easy as it looked like on their opening drive.
So Mike Nugent will kick it away. Eric Weems back deep. This ball, folks, if you got high definition, coming right in your living room. Weems brings it out of the end zone, 4 yards deep. Dives forward and gets to the 10. A 23-yard return, Quan Cosby with the special teams tackle. So Matt Ryan comes back onto the field. Rookie of the year coming out of Boston College. And he had a great opening drive.
He certainly did. Kept stepping up into the pocket, going to his outlet, Michael Turner, then hitting Roddy White on the deep crossing route for the 46-yard gain, and then threading that needle. Great catch, and then, of course, the touchdown to Finner. There's a reason Matt Ryan is 15-1 in this building. You just saw a few reasons for it.
Matt Ryan, big play on that drive, a 46-yard pass to Roddy White on 3rd-and-3 at their own 24. So Cosby had to be helped up. You played special teams all those years.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just collision after collision, yeah, violent collisions on special teams.
Yeah, it's a car wreck. I mean, you can't, there's no, watch how he gets it and he catches the guy, the knee right on the side of the head, and that does it. You know, and you wonder too, Eric Weems got up and walked off. I guess he's okay. But I've been on both ends of that hit. And, yeah, you feel it. It's hard to get out of bed on Monday for those things. You know, I mean, it's just they stick with you. We'll see. Keep an eye on Cosby, see if he's able to continue in the game.
First down and 10 at the 19-yard line. Michael Turner in the backfield. Play fake. Ryan rolling out, throws on the run, and a flag on the play. Incomplete pass intended for Michael Jenkins.
Defense. 12 players on the field. 5-yard penalty. First down.
And there you see once again the sloppiness of Marvin Lewis's team with senseless penalties.
Yeah, and those are and it's just like the first and goal they gave Atlanta down at the other end with a first down they gave him by jumping off sides. You don't even get to compete. I mean, even if Atlanta goes for a touchdown, you don't get to bring it back. I mean, it's just no win situation when you make mistakes before the snap.
First down and 5 at the 24. Turner. And Michael Turner picks up major yardage. Stopped by Dahani Jones, and that takes us to the end of the quarter as Turner gains 9. We'll return to Atlanta after these messages. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Welcome back, 7-3 as we start the second quarter. Gus Johnson, Steve Tasker with you. And for this Bengals squad, if you look at the numbers overall this season, they've been penalized 36 times coming into this game for 274 yards. Their opponents have been penalized 27 times for 189 yards. So that's a lot of penalty yardage there, partner.
Yeah, it's like digging out of a hole every game.
First down and 10. Leonard. At the 33, Michael Turner in the backfield. Ryan Short drop. Sideline.
Take it. Whoa! No, make that Roddy White. One-hand catch for 23 yards out of bounds in front of Adam Jones. And even Adam Jones has the spot.
Yeah, that was a good catch. Watch, he's just going to go out, reaches up, one hand, right hand, gets both feet down.
Wow.
Got, has it. I mean, how do you defend that? I mean, you'd have to be 10 feet tall to defend that play.
Three catches, 87 yards for White. Turner. Down the sideline, steps out of bounds inside Bengal territory at the 30 as he gains 14. Johnson and Leon Hall pushes him out of bounds.
Well, you can understand why Atlanta, you know, some people are, you know, would really love to say they're one of the best teams in the NFC. They've got so many weapons. Michael Turner is a force. Roddy White, Anthony Gonzalez, and Matt Ryan. Hard to keep these guys hemmed in.
Turner, 5 carries, 34 yards. First down at the Bengal 30. Ryan throws it up top. Incomplete. That time it was Michael Jenkins, the intended receiver. Leon Hall, stride for stride with him.
And you'll see Jenkins, you know, Jenkins is a big, big guy. He's 6 feet five and can run. You see there, when he looks forward, the ball's already been thrown and it's behind him. Not the same level of communication with Matt Ryan on that play.
First incompletion for Ryan today. 7 of 8, 102 yards and a touchdown. Second down and 10. Tripped up. Shoestring tackle being made by Morgan Trent. And it's a 3-yard pickup. Now Michael Turner is a star in Atlanta. He finished second in the NFL in rushing at 08. Last season, Turner rushed for 871 yards in just 11 games. And this year, he's ninth in the league in rushing, coming in with 466. Ryan underneath, incomplete. Tony Gonzalez, the intended receiver. And Brandon Johnson there defensively and hit him on the back of the helmet.
Yeah, and we talk about all these guys, Roddy White, Michael Turner, Matt Ryan. Oh, yeah, by the way, they also have the best tight end who's ever strapped it on. Tony Gonzalez getting into the act. I mean, this is a club, and Tony Gonzalez has still got a lot of gas in his tank. I mean, he is a great tight end. As you see, the Falcons settling for a field goal attempt here. But this offense for Atlanta is loaded.
It'll be a 45-yard attempt for Matt Ryan in his ninth year out of Baylor. And good. Nicely done. Falcons take a 10-3 lead with 13:30 remaining in the second quarter. Back to the Georgia Dome after this. Atlanta, Halloween right around the corner. Some people getting off to an early start. The new NFL.com mobile apps have arrived. No matter where you are, you can track scores, set fantasy lineups, and get highlights. Bernard Scott back deep. And Scott to the 20. And he's wrestled down at about the 22-yard line. And we'll do it once again. The new NFL.com mobile app has arrived. No matter where you are, you can track scores, set fantasy lineups, and get highlights of your team's big plays. Go to NFL.com/mobile to learn more. First down at 10 to the 22-yard line for the Bengals, trailing 10-3. Carson Palmer and his squad 2-3 on the season, trying to keep pace with Baltimore and Pittsburgh in the AFC North. After sweeping the division last year, play action. Palmer to the sideline. T.O. goes up high, can't hold on. And that ball knocked out of his hands by Brent Grimes.
And this was a great defensive play by a cornerback on a big receiver. Grimes is 5'10". Owens is 6'3". Watch how he gets up, doesn't touch him, and knocks it away. That is absolutely outstanding. Kept great position and knocked the ball away for the incompletion.
Carson Palmer has missed his last four after starting 3 of 3 for 21 yards. Second and 10. Play action. Palmer underneath. Benson lost and picked up. Grimes, touchdown Falcons. Takes a 16-3 lead.
The only question is, after he takes the play fake, does he catch it and get both feet down? I don't know that he tucked it away. And Marvin Lewis threw the appeal flag, the challenge flag, and rightfully so. It's going to come down to the fact now the officials did the right thing. You got to let this play out. The question is, did Cedric Benson have control of that ball?
Cincinnati is challenging the ruling on the field of a completed pass. Timeout.
They're going to challenge to say the pass was incomplete to begin with.
So we'll see our first challenge of the day.
Here a moment ago, Cedric Benson looked to catch a football, fumble it, and Grimes ran it in for a touchdown. Marvin Lewis is appealing this. Now he's got to have both hands on the ball, tucking it away with each foot on the ground. There's his left foot's down, his right foot. Then the ball comes out. I think this play is going to stand because of that fact right there. He did not bobble the ball. He was tucking it away, but he made a football move in my estimation and got 2 feet on the ground.
Curtis Lofton with a terrific tackle, the middle linebacker.
I think the play stands.
And then Grimes returns the ball 23 yards for a touchdown.
You see there, he's got two hands on it. He's going to tuck it away. Both feet come down, as we said. And then the ball comes out because of the contact of Lofton. And, of course, then it's a room service touchdown.
The receiver does not maintain control of the ball. Therefore, it's an incomplete pass. It will be third down. Cincinnati will not be charged with a timeout. Clock operator, please reset the clock.
They said he did not have control of it. I didn't see him bobble it in any way, shape, or form. You see him get both hands on it, tucks it away. Now they're saying right there he didn't have control of the football.
That's a bad call.
He had each foot on the ground, as we said.
There's a reaction from Curtis Lofton.
There you go.
Benson on the sideline now. Bengals faced with a third down and 10 of the 22. Bernard Scott in the backfield with Carson Palmer. Here's Palmer under pressure. Incomplete. Carson Palmer knocked down in the backfield. Jonathan Babineau almost knocking it out of his hands.
Yeah, Babineau and Abraham coming in from the center. You see it from the back, and Abraham jumping over in between the guard tackle. And Carson Palmer, I tell you, you got to have guts to play quarterback. Stood tall in that pocket as it fell around him.
Eric Weems refuses to pick that one up, and it will be downed at the 31-yard line and a flag on the play. 47-yard punt.
This is going to look. Yeah, it looked like a late block in the back.
Holding number 21. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down, timeout.
There you go.
That's Christopher Owens called for the holding penalty. 12:58 to play in the second quarter. 10-3. Back after this. Welcome back. 10-3 Atlanta with the lead, but it could be a much different ball game if the touchdown would have stood instead. Falcons take over at the 21, giving it to Michael Turner. And he goes down the sideline and gets out of bounds at the 30. A 9-yard gain.
Yeah, Michael Turner getting the edge of that defense. And you talk about, we talked about all the stars on this offense for Atlanta. You know, the thing that goes unnoticed is the fact that the same five guys have started on their offensive line for almost three straight years. That's a huge advantage up front.
Second down and two. Ryan on the play action fake over the middle. As he throws a strike to Weems. Don't make that wide, excuse me, and it's a gain of 19 yards. Wow. Roddy White just finding open space time and time again.
Yeah, and the Atlanta Falcons turning the tables on the Cincinnati Bengals, going no huddle as well. Stepping up right to the line of scrimmage right now and snapping.
White, four catches, 106 yards already. First down at the 48. Ryan to the sideline. And Roddy White again. Leon Hall knocks him out of bounds after an 8-yard gain.
You talk about this, they've got Hall on him. He's not bailing out. He's kind of trying to hang in there. And then they run Ndukwe out from the inside as well. So they're trying to shift the defense toward White, and they're just not getting it done.
114 total yards for White. As Snelling runs the football and picks up a yard on the play.
Well, one of the things that happens to the Falcons, we spoke to them, and Mike Smith told us one of the problems they've had in this season is the fact they haven't been as successful as they want to be on first and second down. And they haven't gotten any first downs on first down. And it's brought up a lot of third and longs, and they haven't been able to stay on the field because of that. Not so today. They've really been successful on the opening downs, probably because they had a chance to focus on it.
Third down and one. Ryan down the field.
Chosinko over there, and they were thinking about getting the ball and who is the best, and he said there's no question. He goes, I want better numbers than those guys.
Extra point good. Matt Ryan with his 49th career touchdown pass, second of the day, and Roddy White showing the entire world that even though T.O. and Ochocinco are on the field, he may be a little bit better. 17-3 Atlanta. Roddy White, what concentration, an incredible route, and a 43-yard touchdown, five plays, 79 yards. And look at his big numbers today for all you fantasy football league guys out there. Michael Kanan, the punter, and who also serves as a kickoff specialist, sends it away. Adam Jones brings it out of the end zone. And Jones at the 20. Adam Jones! Shoestring tackle, and there is a flag down all the way back at the 14-yard line. And
number 86 during the return, half the distance of the goal, first down.
So let's take another look at the touchdown. Matt Ryan connecting with Roddy White.
You can see both ends of this throw. Roddy White's going to go out. And an interesting thing, Roddy White doesn't look for the football until he's 35 yards down the field. Matt Ryan doesn't even see him catch the ball. He has to get up and walk a few feet to watch it. And watch this catch. Doesn't get it on the first time. Tips it up. Holds it in. Never touches the ground. Holds it close to his body. And I'll tell you, skidding across that paint in the end zone, Gus, there's nothing like it.
So a first down for Cincinnati now at their 7-yard line. Bengals have dug a hole for themselves. Benson running left and knocked backwards. Wow. Vance Walker knocked him down. Second year player out of Georgia Tech.
Two inside linebackers coming right up. Played this absolutely perfectly. Perfectly. Peterson, Lofton came right up through the formation, made the tackle.
Second down and 11. Here's Benson looking, breaks it back. Benson with running room. And Benson stopped at the 12-yard line. William Moore with the open field tackle, but it's a gain of 6 on second and 11.
And I spoke to Curtis Lofton. He said one of the problems with Cincinnati is they run this banana play where they hand it off to the left and it breaks back to the right. The issue is not to over pursue it for the defense, and they actually did on that play and gave Benson some space on the backside.
Third down and 4 at the 13. Palmer. Beautiful throw and a catch by T.O. First down, and Owens still fighting for yards after the catch, gets to the 30. Aaron Coleman ushering him out of bounds, but on third and 4 they get 15.
Owens at the top of your screen is going to hit, and that's what makes him so good. He's so big and fast, you really have to give him a cushion or he'll get past you. And then you see he's so strong and physical, he'll shrug blockers off and get the extra yard, make a big play out of a good play.
7 catches for 102 yards and a touchdown against Tampa in their last game. First down to 10 and 28. Palmer again, sideline. T.O. trying to break a tackle, jumps and goes out of bounds as he gets crunched. Owens got him low, as well as Steven Nicholas.
And watch Owens hanging on. Owens hanging on for his dear life for Owens, and then Nicholas comes out and cleans up. But Terrell Owens, physical on the outside, tough to tackle.
First down and 10 of the 39. Benson breaks a tackle. And Benson gets to the 45, gains 6 yards. Curtis Lofton, the middle linebacker, making the tackle. Cincinnati quickly getting back to the line of scrimmage.
It all comes down to it, Gus. If you want to play good defense in the NFL, the first guy to the ball has to make the tackle. It's been going well for Atlanta, but in the last this series, you can see they're starting to miss a few tackles.
Let's see if Carson Palmer looks for Ocho Cinco. He's been quiet recently. Second and 4 at the 45. Benson hopping, skipping, dodging, and running hard. Gets to the Atlanta 45. That's a 9-yard gain. Christopher Owens and Brian Williams combining on the tackle.
Well, we talked about the two running backs in the beginning of the game. Cedric Benson and Michael Turner. You see there the hop, the double cut, you know, the hop, skip, and the cut with 2 feet.
Palmer looking down the field. That's a miscommunication. That was Ocho Cinco's side, and he says, my bad.
And he's holding his hand up for a route. He says, this is what I thought I was supposed to run. You'll see he's going to come off and he's just going to break this route off because of the coverage or because he thought that was the right route. Carson Palmer saw something else, thought something else, and threw the ball deep.
And a flag thrown prior to the start.
Number 71, offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
It's Andre Smith, the second year man out of Alabama, starting on the line today.
They got the start in place of Dennis Rowland. And that's the kind of penalty that just makes a drive stall. Well, Bengals playing extremely well, moving the ball up out of their own end, down inside their 15-yard line, all the way out to midfield, and all of a sudden, things start to go sideways because they have a miscommunication and then a penalty.
4 penalties, 21 yards against the Bengals, second and 15. Palmer underneath, and Terrell Owens is there again. T.O. picks up 7, Owens and Nicholas. Binding on the tap.
And they've been running this route quite a bit. You'll see crossing route with Gresham goes to the outside. Owens just curls it on the outside and makes the catch. Quick 7 yards.
Third down and 8 at the 44. They need to go to the 36 for first down. They're 3 of 6 on third down conversions. And Mike Smith is on the field. So Atlanta calling a timeout.
You talk about the three guys that are catching a lot of passes. Well, have caught a lot of passes. Look at this. This is a big game.
This first half.
First big quarter and a half. There's no question. Those guys are the engines that make their offense run. They're the big play specialists. They're the go-to guys. They're the security lane. Call it what you want.
Roddy White, very interesting. He has 22 100-yard games and only 44 career games played. What a player.
That is good.
Third down and 8 at the 44. Bengals need to go to the 36 for first down. Ocho Cinco at the top of your screen. T.O. at the bottom and another flag thrown.
Now Cincinnati's going to take a timeout.
Offense, 12 men to huddle.
Wow.
5-yard penalty, still third down.
I think they're going to pick the flag up because the Bengals had called a timeout. This last sequence of plays will give you an idea of why the Bengals are 2-3 and not 4-1. They had too many men in the huddle. They took an illegal procedure penalty to back them up. And they had to waste a timeout to keep from getting another penalty. So, I mean, this is the kind of thing that has kept the Bengals from reaching their full potential this season.
Third down and 13 at the 49. Palmer. And Trevor. Of the day, Brian Williams and Nicholas get to him first, a loss of 6.
And they brought extra pressure, and you'll see it right up through the middle, right up through the heat, and then the secondary gets there on the outside as Williams comes in, and then oof, that hurts.
So Kevin Huber punting from the 27. He had a career-long 72-yard punt last week against Tampa Bay, or 2 weeks ago against Tampa Bay. Ball fair caught at the 17 by Eric Weems, a 42-yard punt. Now coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report, join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cowell for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. It's coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Ryan, great leadership skills for this young quarterback. Hit the ground running when he came out of BC, won the Rookie of the Year honors. First down and 10 to 17. And Turner, holding ball, picks up a couple. Well, actually, no gain on the play as Rivers comes up with the tackle. How about Matt Ryan, Steve?
Well, what can you say about him? His third year as a starter, his rookie of the year, his rookie year. And I think you remember back then, that was when Michael Turner rushed for 1,700 yards. That helps a young quarterback. And now he's good enough after that season to carry it on his own shoulders.
Second down and 10 at the 17. Hand off Turner again. Crosses the 20. Down, but the Falcons ground and pound, a gain of 36.
I'll tell you what, the Bengals have got 8 guys in the box and run a 9th one down in there with the motion, and Michael Turner runs right through the middle of it. Everybody gets a hat on a hat, breaks a tackle. As we said, that's what happens to defenses who go south. They miss tackles, 2 of them missed, and it turns into the huge play.
9 carries, 82 yards for Turner. Jason Snelling comes in to give him a rest. First down at the 46, play action. Ryan throws backside, incomplete. Michael Palmer, rookie tight end out of Clemson. Intended receiver, Keith Rivers covered.
You know, Ryan, Ryan gets this pressure, you know, that Bengals doing everything they can to make sure they stop the run, throwing everything into the box, and then sending some pressure after Ryan.
It looked like a Houston Texans play. Matt Schaub throwing backside to Owen Daniels. Second down and 10 at the 46. Matt Ryan over the middle. Snelling with the catch. And he goes down close to the first down. Dahani Jones with the tackle, a 9-yard gain.
We spoke about, you know, Atlanta allowing a lot of points in the first quarter. But from the second through the fourth quarter, those last three quarters of all the games, they outscore everybody. And, look at that. These are the good teams that they're playing in. That tells you what kind of offense Atlanta has and how their defense rises up. This is a team with a little resolve. Been in two overtime games already this season, went 1-1 in those.
Here's the pitch. Gartrell Johnson down the sideline. Stiff arm. And he gets his first carry of the day. And Dukeway pushed him out of bounds, but Johnson picks up 23.
You'll see seven guys in the box for the Bengals, and the misdirection causes him just to miss. And then look at Tony Gonzalez right out in front, putting the block on Crocker right there. Gets his hands inside, runs him, lets him go where he wants to, lets him go so he doesn't get called for the hole, and good discipline after a great block.
First down and 10 at the Cincinnati 14. 4 minutes to play in the first half. Snelling. And this time Snelling tackled quickly as Gathers gets to him first.
The Cincinnati Bengals right now, they're looking up at the scoreboard 17-3 with 3.5 minutes in the first half, and they're thinking, wow, what happened here? And you look back and it's just been one or two little things, some penalties, and it hasn't been so much that they have missed opportunities defensively, but offensively with penalties, they have.
Second and 9 out of the backfield. Snelling again, and Snelling stopped by Adam Jones in the open field. And we talk about penalties, Cincinnati today. 5 penalties, 26 yards, but the timing of the penalties have really hurt them.
Yeah, and they've been pre-snap, and they had to waste a timeout to avoid another penalty. And, you know, Marvin Lewis, and they said to us, you know, they have really, during their bye week, they focused on some of that and talked to each other about how they could do it. Now we have a player down on the field on the far side.
That's Adam Jones.
Adam Jones, he was out there, but he had to take a knee and ask for the play to be stopped because he couldn't continue. He'll make his way off. And that's a smart play by Jones. Something was wrong. He took a minute. He said, listen, I can't go. You got to stop. This is the tackle he had on Snelling.
May have caught a stinger in his shoulder.
Yeah.
Last season, Jones released by Dallas in February. Didn't play the rest of the year. He's been in and out of trouble during his career and has turned over. New attitude in Cincinnati, and his coaches are proud of his progress. Third down and 9 at the 13. Matt Ryan steps up, fires, and this is Michael Jenkins. Jenkins diving for the first down marker. He's close in front of Johnson and Morgan Trent.
Mike Smith, he's thinking about it. He says they're going to go for it. They're going to wait for the 2-minute warning, and then they'll talk about going for it. I think it's a smart move. You know, you're up by 14, 2 touchdowns. Maybe it is the time to maybe put it away early.
So it looks like the Falcons will go for it on fourth down. They're 5 of 7 this season. They need a yard. Turner, Snelling in the backfield. Turner running. Leans forward and picks it up. Dahani Jones with the tackle, but that makes it first down and goal. for Atlanta at the two.
Well, nothing fancy. Just get a lead blocker for Turner, trying to get him at the point of attack and let him find a crack in the defense, roll up for the first down. Cincinnati does an actually a pretty good job of defending it, but it's just so tough when it's such short yardage and you got a back like Turner running it. It always looks easy when a guy goes for it on fourth down and they pick it up like that. Guess it's not easy.
So they spot it at the 4-yard line. Michael Turner, the lone setback. Turner. And Turner leans forward. Gets to about the 2-yard line.
Cincinnati will take a quick timeout there.
So the Bengals with two timeouts remaining. Falcons with two timeouts remaining. Coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. Join JB, Dan, Shannon, Boomer, and Coach Cowher for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. It's coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report. What a job Coach Smith has done, Steve, since coming to this Falcons team.
Well, it is his team now, and it's his guys, his roster, his philosophy, and it has really worked. And of course, it helps when you get that quarterback who can really pull the trigger, and you have a great player like Roddy White. You'd get Gonzalez in a trade. Things really have come together, and it really is a testament to the Falcon organization.
11th play of the drive that started at 17. Turner leading in. Touchdown. Michael Turner gives Atlanta a 23-3 lead.
Well, that says a lot on those three downs. First and go, fourth and two, they get it. First and 10, they get it, and then the touchdown.
Extra point good. 11 play drive covering 83 yards. Falcons controlling the ball for 5 minutes and 31 seconds as Michael Turner caps it off with the run over the right side.
Yeah, Gus, this is three straight runs, one on the fourth down to pick it up, and then two more runs get the Falcons into the end zone, and that's a dominant performance by the offensive line. Getting up to the second level, you see Dahl getting a hat on the linebackers, just getting up there, pushing through into the end zone. I mean, that's a statement drive right there.
Turner.
Michael Turner punching it in. Short yardage twice.
13th drive of 5 minutes or more this season leads the NFL. And when you look at the Cincinnati team, if you look up and down the bench, the Bengals look unorganized, and they look, Steve, like they just don't have a spark.
Yeah, they're flat, and that, there's no question their defense is discouraged right now. They got to sit over there and say, man, we gave up a bad drive, so they're going to be down. But the offense, somebody has got to pick them up and get them sparked. You see there, after the bye week, it's not just this year.
Body language, very good indicator. And the Falcons will sit on it. And Scott wrapped up on the play by Brent Grimes, who also plays on special teams, a 22-yard return Tuesday. She had a beautiful mind, but it's her body language that will solve this case. Don't miss TV's number one drama, NCIS, Tuesday only on CBS. Here's Michael Turner with LaDainian Tomlinson's backup in San Diego. Turner playing at Northern Illinois. Stand out there, first down and 10. At the 24. Carson Palmer in the shotgun. And he finds Scott on the screen. And Scott chased down by Curtis Lofty after a 6-yard gain.
Cincy's really going to make some hay. They'd love to go in at least with a field goal opportunity with 40 seconds and counting. They're going to hurry up and try and get down there to do that.
Palmer firing. And this time it's caught by the tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the rookie out of Oklahoma as he picks up five.
Yeah, it's too early to check it in if you're the Bengals. You're down by three touchdowns in the first half. You've got to cut. You've got to stay tough. And you've got the weapons to do it. We've been talking about them all day. Gresham at tight end. Ocho Cinco, Owens, Cedric Benson. This is an offense that has weapons. They've got to have faith in them and put them. And Carson Palmer has got to get the football to them.
First down and 10 at the 35. Underneath. Nice catch by Shipley, and he gets dropped. Greg Grimes and Steven Nicholas, who have combined on tackles numerous times in this game. 9-yard gain.
Well, Shipley's just back into the game after getting a concussion earlier in the season. And you can see this is a good hit by Grimes. That hurt.
He may get fined for that hit.
He was
is
high.
That helmet to helmet?
I don't know. He kind of tried to hold his head off of Shipley. I don't know if he actually did it.
George Shipley was on the receiving end of a vicious hit from Cleveland's T.J. Ward of the Bengals. Week 4 loss. Shipley suffered a concussion when he was hit by Ward in the head, reaching for a ball in the end zone. Ward was flagged for a personal foul and fined $15,000 by the league. Check this out.
Yeah, that's pretty high.
Second down and 1 at the 44. Josica, and he gets out of bounds. It's an 8-yard gain. Rick Grimes knocks him out of bounds.
And this is going to give the Bengals an opportunity to sort of immediate gain right here. They got to get to the 40-yard line to make it, you know, like a 58-yard attempt. So they've got to get another 10 or 12 yards for a reasonable field goal attempt. But if there's only 1 second left, you know, why not try the 65-yarder or the Hail Mary? But they're going to get a chance to go for some points right before the half, unless they take a loss right here.
First down at the 47 of Atlanta. Palmer throwing down the sideline, and Ocho Cinco, the attendant receiver, incomplete. Carson Palmer doesn't look happy with Chad Ocho Cinco.
Told us it's been the details that have held. You see there, he let up. He did not believe the ball was coming to him. He didn't run hard enough, and Carson Palmer wants him to run harder.
Second down and 10 at the 47. Palmer again. Ocho Cinco, this time he drops it.
Come to you and then come back on a ball thrown right at your face and let it go through your hands. And 2 weeks ago in Tampa Bay, Chad Ocho Cinco deflected an interception late that gave Tampa Bay a chance to win that football game. And here today, another drop at a time when the Bengals can ill afford it.
It'd be nice to see Chad Johnson again. Third down and 10 at the 47. Over the middle, Shipley, nice catch in traffic at the 35. And Cincinnati,
there it is,
picks up 12 yards of the ball, their final timeout.
Shipley right in the slot is going to come turn just to the outside and just pivot and come down with it. I don't know whether that was to Shipley or to Owens. Either way, that was a well-run two-minute drill for the Bengals. If Chad Ocho Cinco, mistakes or not, they're going to end up with an opportunity to go for a long field goal.
So here comes Mike Nugent. Ball spotted at the 35. Nugent good for 20 yards today. This will be a 53-yard attempt. Timeout called by Atlanta. My Mike Nugent made a pair of 50-yard field goals this year. Week one at New England, Nugent tied his career long with the 54-yard field goal. And week three at Carolina, Nugent hit a 50-yard field goal. Now he'll attempt one from 53 yards away. His sixth season out of Ohio State.
Yeah, this would be huge psychologically for the Bengals to come out and get 3 points in the half. Really, just to give them something positive to come out with it. Get back within three touchdowns.
Down, up, and no good. So we head to halftime. 24-3 Atlanta. We'll be back with the Sprint halftime report after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Falcons lead Cincinnati 24-3 at halftime. Gus Johnson along with Steve Tasker. Steve, in the first half, Falcons looked sharp. Bengals looked not so sharp.
No, they didn't. The Bengals looked a little bit disorganized, took up some penalty, pre-snap penalties. The mistakes on their own have really kept them from putting anything offensively together. They did put a nice two-minute drill together right before the half, but it ended up in a missed field goal. So that's one reason they're three touchdowns down to a really good offense with the Atlanta Falcons. Matt Ryan is clicking on all cylinders.
All right, let's take a look at the points of protection brought to you by Allstate.
Well, usually when a team's down three touchdowns, they've turned it over once or twice, but neither team turned the football over in the first half. Roddy White, the huge first half with the touchdown. Cincinnati has zero sacks defensively. Atlanta's gotten one against Carson Palmer. And, of course, Matt Ryan, 13 of 16 with a couple of touchdowns. And one guy that has not been a factor thus far in the game is Tony Gonzalez. And with the time that the Atlanta Falcons have spent down in the red zone, you'd think that would be the case where they'd go to their big tight end. But, in fact, they've run the ball when they got down close and been able to score that way. So look for Gonzalez perhaps to get some catches in the second half.
Ocho Cinco. Three catches, 25 yards. Adam Jones brings it out of the end zone. And Jones, nice return, gets all the way up to the 25, and that's a 29-yard return. Spencer Atkins with the tackle defensively. Carson Palmer, 11 of 20, 95 yards in the first half. No interceptions, no touchdowns, obviously.
Yeah, and there's no question they've got to adjust their game plan from coming in. They wanted to stay very balanced, move down the football field methodically. I don't think you can do that trailing by three touchdowns to the Atlanta Falcons in this dome. I think you've got to come out and throw the football and do some things to get big chunks of yardage. This Atlanta defense has given up big plays this year. You've got to get some if you're the Bengals.
From the 26, first down. T.O. in motion, lines up at the top of your screen, receiver position. Palmer throwing on first down to the sideline. Josico out of bounds at the 36 as he ran the out route and picks up 10 yards on the play.
And the Bengals making some quick substitutions here on the fly and going no huddle. That's just a quick out route. Trying to get something offensively. They're going to have to air it out here. Now, they will run it occasionally, but you can bet Carson Palmer is going to have more attempts in the passing game this half than he did the first.
First down to the 36, Benson. And Benson gets to the 41. Steve has done a great job in this game running the football. He runs hard, 13 carries, 62 yards so far.
Yeah, Cedric Benson hasn't been the problem. The problem has been that when they do have some positive things happen offensively, they get a false start or an illegal formation or too many men in the huddle, and it brings them back.
Second down at six at the 40. Play fake, Palmer, Ocho Cinco with room, and Ocho Cinco crosses the 45, gets up to the 47, picks up 7 yards. Steven Nicholas and William Moore bring him down.
Yeah, this is just a quick wide receiver screen as you see Gresham come out to pick up Owens. Ocho Cinco gets what he can get.
Ocho Cinco, 2 catches to start the second half. 5 for 42 thus far. First down at the 47. Palmer straight drop. Near side. Ocho Cinco again. And Ocho Cinco gets inside Falcon territory. Christopher Owens with the tackle, and it's a 9-yard gain.
And already some positive things happening for Cincinnati. You can bet they went in and had a real session, X's and O's session, about what's going to work against this Atlanta defense and what they've got to do. And this first series is crucial for the Bengals to get back in this game.
Second down and one at the Atlanta 44. Palmer now finds Vincent on a screen. And Vincent gets inside the 40. Nice running. Gets 6 yards. Curtis Lofton with the tackle. And Cedric Benson, Steve, is having a good day.
Yeah, and they're using him every way they can possibly do it. They're handing him the football. Plus, he's breaking tackles and getting into the secondary. And this is what he's so good at, Gus, is making a guy miss in tight quarters, running through arm tackles, getting extra yards after contact. It's been a real successful day for Benson so far.
First down and 10. Benson running left this time. And Vincent. Jamal Anderson and Vance Walker just gobbling him up, and that's a 1-yard pickup.
Yeah. That wasn't an arm tackle that Vance Walker just put on Cedric Benson. That was a body tackle. This is a wrap-up. Oof. Gotcha. And that's where the play ends.
Second down and 9. At the 37. Palmer 4 for 4 on this drive. Carson Palmer. Out route again. Ocho Cinco turns it up at the 25, and then he dances down to the 24-yard line. Christopher Owen with the tackle. Owens gives up a 14-yard reception to Ocho Cinco.
Yeah, Atlanta was in their dime package with 6 defensive backs on the field, and they brought pressure as well. So Owens was on an island against Ocho Cinco, and Carson Palmer had plenty of time to get rid of that football right when he wanted to.
First down and 10 at the 23. Bengals having no problems moving the ball on their first possession of the second half. Palmer, that one deflected, and Palmer bats it down. Great job there by John Abraham, getting pressure on the quarterback and knocking that football into the air.
And this is a design play. Gresham just lets Abraham go. And that was part of the design of the play, to get Abraham out of the way, let him run away from where they're going to throw it. The problem is Carson Palmer's got to miss him when he throws that football out there. John Abraham, a great veteran, back into great shape this year after a hard offseason he put himself through.
Second and 10 of the 23. T.O., top of your screen. A handoff, Benson. And Benson, take it down from behind. Nicely done. Vance Walker, no gain on the play.
As we said early on in this second half, down 3 touchdowns, the Bengals are not going to do anything in the run game. I mean, that running play was token at best. You're going to throw the football if you're going to win this football game.
Third down and 10 of the 23. They're 4 of 8 on third down conversion. Owens up top. Ocho Cinco at the bottom. Reggie Kelly, Cedric Benson in the backfield. Here's Palmer. Underneath, and it's caught by Jordan Shipley. And Shipley on 3rd and 10 picks up 8.
They're going to bring all kinds of pressure. You can see a 7-man rush from the Atlanta Falcons. There was man-to-man coverage all over the football field. And they said, if you want to throw it short of the first down, go ahead. We'll let you convert it, but you're not going to have time to look twice. And that's exactly what happened to the Atlanta Falcons. They got a 7-man rush, got there. Carson Palmer had to settle for less than the first down.
Mike Nugent, who missed that 53-yarder at the end of the first half, comes in to attempt a 33-yard field goal. And this is good. Bengals trying to get a little momentum. 24-6, back after this. Take a look at the receivers and Carson Palmer having a conversation. As they go on that 11-play, 59-yard drive, heating up 5:26, mostly the no huddle. Ocho Cinco 4 for 40 on the drive as Nugent knocked down a 33-yard field goal.
Yeah, they were exclusively three wide receiver set in that series, and they lined the tight end up in the backfield once in a while with Benson.
So Weems in his own end zone, and he brings it out. Crosses the 15 and goes backwards. 22-yard return, and here comes Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons offense for the first time in the second half right after this. Atlanta, Georgia, downtown, and the Falcons come back on the field. And we, as we mentioned, Steve, during the top of our broadcast, this Falcons team offensively with a lot of weapons. Tony Gonzalez hasn't even had a reception today.
Yeah, they targeted him once. That guy has. Roddy White has had a lot of them. Yeah. Sooner or later, Gonzalez is going to get on the board.
First down and 10 at the 18. Bryant, there you go. Tony Gonzalez with his first reception as he gains 5.
I guess it was sooner rather than later.
And Duque and Rivers combining on the tackle.
Watch here. He spent a lot of time just blocking today. Faked the block that time, comes out and gets his first reception of the day. Has been really, really a great addition, particularly, I think, for Matt Ryan, not just because he's a weapon, but also he's a veteran who you can learn some things from.
Only tight end in NFL history with 1,000 career catches. Turner straight ahead, and he's got another big opening. Michael Turner with the low center of gravity gains 15 yards. Keith Rivers, first man to him, and now Turner has gone over 100 yards for the day.
They're going to get a nice trap block coming across. You see the low block there on Maualuga. It allows Turner to get right up inside between the two guards, right up through the middle of the formation. A great trap block coming back across.
First down and 10 at the 38. Turner runs into a wall as he runs left. No gain.
Yeah, the Bengals had 9
men. And Duque gets up limping, and he was at the bottom of the pile.
Certainly, because they had 9 guys in the box between the tackles. I mean, it's unbelievable. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and there's a 9th one right there. That's hard to run up inside there. And Duque, you see, coming in off the secondary.
Second down and 10 at the 38. Ryan in the shotgun, pumps, fires to the far side. Nice over-the-shoulder grab by Jason Snelling as he gains 4 yards. Chinadum and Duque again with the tackle. Roddy White, you know, receivers are some tough blockers when they want to be.
Yeah, I mean, you can see how he releases from the line of scrimmage, getting 2 guys on him. He's fighting. It's a running, I've said a lot, it's a running fist fight out there. I mean, you can take a swing, get your shot in while you can.
Third down and 6 at the 42. Bryant, over the middle, incomplete. Tony Gonzalez, the intended receiver. He had both hands on the football, just couldn't bring it in. You don't see that happen too often. Now,
Crocker was well defended. Watch right there. You see him get outside, then come back underneath. Crocker undercuts it and almost gets a hand on it. Looks like he got in the vision of Gonzalez, and that ball had some spice on it.
So the Falcons will punt it away. Adam Jones is back deep. Caden at the 28. Jones getting away from the football, now picks it up on the hop, and Jones is tackled at the 12. A 51-yard punt and a 4-yard return. Steven Nicholas with the tackle, and here comes Ocho Cinco.
A few moments ago before the Bengals came on the field, Carson Palmer and Chad Ocho Cinco talked about how Carson Palmer wants Chad to finish a route, and Chad Ocho Cinco finally getting the message, ironing a few wrinkles out in their offense before they come on the field.
Well, here they go from the 12-yard line. Palmer to throw it. And it's caught by Bernard Scott out of the backfield. He lost his footing, only picked up 2 yards, but Cincinnati going with the no huddle again. Mike Peterson with the tackle for Atlanta.
Well, they started the game in this no huddle as well, had some success, but as we've said, most of their success today has been sabotaged by their own mistakes.
Second down and 8 at the 14. Scott remains in the game. Play action. Carson Palmer underneath. Oh, what a nice throw as Owens cradles it and crosses the 30. A 17-yard game.
This Ocho Cinco comes out, gets up the field on Grimes, and snaps off a deep slant route. Grimes defends it pretty well, but it's a well-thrown ball, and Johnson, or Ocho Cinco, really does a nice job hanging on to it in traffic.
First down and 10 at the 32.
Disciplined route, just coming straight off the line as hard as he can, and then breaking it off sharply across the field and going up and getting the high throw from Palmer
from the 48-yard line. Carson Palmer, T.O. at the Atlanta 45, still running, finally knocked down as he picks up 8 yards.
Everything he can to get out every last yard that's coming to him. It's been against Christopher Owens just about all day. Did a nice job on him.
Carson Palmer down the seam. Oh, he's got the rookie, Jordan Shipley. Beautiful catch and a nice throw by Palmer. Eric Coleman stops him, and it's a gain of 30 yards.
Well, one of the things that's happened now, Atlanta, you see the pressure right in Palmer's face. He still gets rid of it. But Palmer's going to get this right up in his grill.
First down at the 14. And some movement on the offensive line, and that may be another Andre Smith.
Another mistake by Cincinnati when they get some success. They come down and jump off sides again. Time and time again throughout the first month and a half of the season, the Bengals have just done this time and time again, and it's just things like that that cause you to lose games.
Six penalties, 31 yards for Cincinnati. Three penalties, 41 yards for Atlanta. First down at 15 at the 19-yard line. Play fake. Palmer looks backside. T.O. Terrell Owens. Touchdown, Cincinnati. His 147th career touchdown catch, third most in NFL history behind Jerry Rice and Randy Moss.
And he just put the big stiff arm on Eric Coleman. Watch as he catches this. He'll go up through the gap by Whitworth and just oof. Big, strong, physical receiver just stiff-armed his way to the end zone.
Nugent for the extra point, and it's good. Six plays, 88 yards. Cincinnati eats up 318, and they're trying to scratch their way back into this game. 3:39 to play. Third quarter, 24-13. Welcome back to Atlanta. 24-13 the score.
Where you see Eric Coleman
with his head down trying to gather himself. Terrell Owens, the guy who stiff-armed him on his way to the end zone. I'll tell you what, it's hard to tackle in the end of the 30.
And it's a 25-yard return. Scuda with the tackle and another look at the touchdown. T.O. for six. Productive third quarter for Ocho Cinco and T.O. Let's see if they can keep up with the momentum. Here's Turner running first and 10 at the 31 for Atlanta. A 2-yard pickup.
Because we were talking earlier in this game, and now after the half, when Cincinnati's kind of awakened, you can see the body language changing on the bench and also on the field defensively. Guys clapping, more animated, finally feeling like they've got a chance in this game.
Now Atlanta goes no huddle, up the sideline, incomplete. Michael Jenkins, closest man to the football. Great job by Leon Hall covering.
See the coverage there. You've got a linebacker walked out. That's Johnson walked out on Turner. And then, of course, there's Mike Zimmer, the defensive coordinator. 18th against the pass. Or 13th against the pass, 18th against the rush. Trying to dial in some pressure.
Bengals want to get off the field here on 3rd and 8 at the 33. Ryan in the shotgun. Ryan looks down the sideline.
Cincinnati Bengals absolutely explode on their sidelines after this tremendous interception by Leon Hall, going up and snagging it. Look at the guys jump up off the bench. They're feeling it now here on the road for the first time today. The Bengals have got a spark.
And that's what the players talked about in our meetings yesterday, Steve. Emotion. Celebrating when teammates do well. First and 10. Here's Benson looking. And Benson brought down by Mike Peterson. But yesterday, Tank Johnson last week was the catalyst for the Cincinnati team when he stood up in front of everybody and said, we have to pat each other on the back a little bit more.
Yeah, you got to cheer for each other. It really helps your production because guys realize then they're not just playing for their own, for themselves. They're playing for everybody in the locker room, everybody on the bench, the coaching staff, and all. And it really makes a difference.
Second and 10 at the 38-yard line. Benson. And Benson goes nowhere. Great pressure. That's Walker. A loss of 2. Buffalo taking on Baltimore.
Baltimore back to the commercial voice, Gus Johnson.
Third down at 12 at the 36. Carson Palmer in the shotgun. Here, Atlanta bringing everybody underneath, and it's the rookie again. Shipley with room. Shipley down the sideline. Shipley at the 20. Cuts it inside. Touchdown, Bengals. And Arthur Cardiac catch back. What a block by T.O. 64 yards.
And you can see it. They're going to go for 2 to make it a 21-24 game. As Shipley caught the side adjust, Shipley making the adjustment that Atlanta Falcons brought the kitchen sink and everything they could at Carson Palmer, and he hung in there and got rid of it to the right guy.
And the Bengals are going for 2. Shipley, 5 catches, 123, and a touchdown. Cincinnati breaks to the line of scrimmage. Ocho Cinco, Shipley at the top. T.O. at the bottom. Benson in the backfield for Carson Palmer. Palmer rolling. Looking. Throwing. Incomplete. Ocho Cinco, the intended receiver.
Trying to stretch the defense sideline to sideline. Palmer puts it out there, and that's a catch. You'd love to have your receiver make.
Jordan Shipley with his first career touchdown, and when he got out in space, a hard man to catch.
Yeah, you see the Falcons bring absolutely everybody they can. And that's just it. I mean, William Moore was matched up with him as a safety trying to come up and cover him. You see all the rushers. Shipley comes out, just looks for the football because that's built into the play. If they bring that many people, the Bengals couldn't protect against them, and you have to get rid of the ball right now. Palmer saw it. Shipley saw it. They executed it absolutely perfectly, and Shipley was off to the races.
Cincinnati, after a lethargic first half, finally everybody playing and coaching with emotion and spirit. And these are the Bengals that came back in so many games last year.
I'll tell you what, winning is nice, but comeback wins are awesome.
Carson Palmer, 24-34, 306, two touchdowns, no picks. And here's the play that created the spark, Leon Hall.
What an athletic play. Trying to find Michael Jenkins. Ball's underthrown. Leon Hall, we spoke to him yesterday, said the same thing. We've got to make plays.
Eric Weems, a yard deep, comes out of the end zone, gets to the 20. Nice move. 30. Down the sideline. And he gets out at the 45. Weems setting up his blocks nicely. A 55-yard return. Brandon G with a tackle.
Catches it a yard deep, and so many times, Gus, what you do as a returner, you go one way, get the coverage to suck over there to that side of the field, and then put your foot in the ground and go back the other direction. He gets the big break right there as he makes that last guy miss. That opens it up.
First down and 10 at the 46 now for Atlanta. Starting inside Cincinnati territory. Sideline. Guess who? Roddy White. Lost it. Picked up.
Touchdown. Picks. Adam Jones. Wow.
And you know the Bengals are going to hurry up and get on the field and kick the extra point before anybody has a chance to review this. Roddy White trying to fight for extra yards. Gets it stripped by Brandon Johnson. No, it was Jones who stripped it. And I think that's a clean fumble. That is out. A touchdown. What a sensational play by Adam Jones. Pulls it out when his team needed it the most. Two tremendous defensive plays, one by Leon Hall, one by Adam Jones, to put the Bengals in the driver's seat. And this is going to be challenged by Mike Smith. Let's have another look at that play. Is Roddy White's knee down when the ball comes loose?
Wow, it's close.
Wow, it's close.
No,
it's a fumble.
That's a fumble.
Right there. You see the ball is out, and you see the knee is up, and the ball is out. That is a tremendous defensive play by Adam Jones to give his team the lead.
And just like that, the Cincinnati Bengals come back and take the lead with 1:16 to go in the third quarter. Wow. What What a turnaround for this young man. We spent a lot of time talking to Marvin Lewis yesterday about Pac-Man and how he's starting to learn things that he had never learned, dating back to, well, Marvin Lewis saying, I wish I would have had him when he was a ninth grader.
Right. You got a chance to mentor him. But no question, he's supremely gifted. And Marvin told us for the first time, he's ready to learn.
The player catches the ball, possesses the ball, and prior to going down, the ball comes loose. Therefore, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Atlanta will be charged with the first timeout.
A big play here in the third quarter as Adam Jones strips it, picks it up, and scores a touchdown.
One last look. Adam Jones getting his hand in there, doing exactly what he should have done, and executing that technique perfectly.
Two-point conversion. Benson in the backfield. Here's the fade. Incomplete. It just should go again.
They really had to go for two both times. The last time was a 19-24 game. If they get the two-point conversion, it turns into a field goal game, and it's the exact same thing now. They're up by 1 point, one more point. 2 points doesn't do them any good. You got to get a three-point advantage so that if the Falcons do get a field goal, it's still tied up. And that's it. 22 points in 8 minutes, 18 seconds. There's the turnaround they were looking for at halftime.
What a game this is turning out to be here in Atlanta.
Now, if you're the Atlanta Falcons, you're just going to take a deep breath and remember, you've done nothing that you haven't inflicted upon yourself. They have not stopped you. They had a great couple of plays, an underthrown ball to Roddy White, and then the fumble put them in a bad position. But this offense still has to feel like they can't stop us. And right now, the Bengals are about as wired as they can be.
And that's what you want to see if you're a Cincinnati Bengals fan. That kind of energy, that kind of enthusiasm. Let's take a look at the receivers today.
We know what the first half was. This is the second half. That's the difference.
So Nugent will punt it away. Eric Reeves gets to the 25 before being wrapped up and taken down. That's a 28-yard return. And Scuda comes up with the tackle. So Roddy White back on the field after fumbling the last time he touched the ball.
Yeah, he'll want to make up for that as well, no question. And you can bet that Mike Mularkey, the offensive coordinator for the Falcons, will call his number, I think, early in this drive.
First down and 10 at the 26. Atlanta, let's see how they play now. Trailing as Turner gets it to the 30. Gathers with the tackle, 4-yard gain.
I think if you're Atlanta, you got to stay with your game plan. Stay balanced. They came out in a two tight end set with one wide receiver, and they're going to go physical and try and push this pile and bull their way down the field. I don't know that I agree with that. I'd like to. Eric, you've got those weapons. You got to use them. Trust your quarterback. Trust your offense.
Second down and 6 at the 30-yard line. Ryan in the shotgun. Ryan. Oh, what a catch. Roddy White. Pulled it up off the turf and picks up 13.
Pulling up off the turf with one hand. Ooh. I knew that they would call his number early on, but what? Look at that. Are you kidding me?
Great catch. 8 catches, 175 yards for White. And that takes us to the end of the third quarter. A 1-point game will return to Atlanta. After this message and a word from your local station, you're watching the National Football League. a turn of events here in Atlanta as the Bengals scored 22 points in the third quarter. And now we have a one-point game as we start the fourth. First down and 10 at the 43. Ryan in trouble. Scrambling. Ryan just dumps it. Incomplete. Turner, the intended receiver, in front of Keith Rivers. And right before the fourth quarter started, Marvin Lewis was hot.
Yeah, he came out on the field when Roddy White caught that ball and rolled out. Adam Jones came up and touched him down. Morgan Trent did not touch him. He was guarding him, and he didn't take the time to go over and touch him after this reception. You'll see this. You saw the great catch by White. Now he'll roll over. He's not down yet. There, he's down because Jones touches him.
Over the middle. Midfield. Turner with a block outside. And Turner goes out of bounds at the 37. In Dukeway there, but it's a 19-yard reception for Michael Turner.
Yeah, the Falcons got to be looking across the way. In the first half, they were playing a team that absolutely had no heartbeat at all. Now the Bengals are jacked up. I mean, they are caffeinated. They are so fired up. They're flying all over the field. That was a great play by Turner, but all of a sudden, the Atlanta Falcons are finding themselves playing against a really inspired football team.
At the Cincinnati 38. Play action. Ryan, deep. Ryan scrambles. Now he heads to the sideline and gets out of bounds at the 34.
If you remember early in the game, Ryan broke contain and got a first down. It was actually called back because of a hold, but whenever that happens, you can bet that sooner or later in the game it's going to come back, because the only time a quarterback breaks contain is when the defense forces him to, and when you do it early, you figure they're going to be able to do it the rest of the game. Matt Ryan, you knew at some point, was going to have to extend the play and make a play, and he still may have to do it on this drive.
Second down and 5 to the 33. High formation. Ryan lets it fly. Stride for stride. Leon Hall has had a terrific second half, including an interception.
And he is in perfect position on Roddy White. Watch as he gets on him. Now he's ahead of him, and Roddy White actually pulls his left arm down to make him not be able to extend for the football. And of course, Matt Ryan's going to feel the pressure. Doesn't look like much, but it does remind the quarterback that he better throw the football.
Third down and 5 at the 33. Atlanta 3 of 8 on third down conversions. Matt Ryan up top. Tony Gonzalez. And Gonzalez with the first down at the 12. He used his height, got a step. And Tony Gonzalez picks up 22.
Matt Ryan throws this up really early, and he told us Gonzalez has tried to teach Matt Ryan to throw the football high to his back shoulder. Says, I promise you I'll catch it. Throw it up there high, no matter where the defender is, I promise you I'll come down with it. Usually they do it down close to the end zone. In this case, they got the first down.
And a timeout on the field called by Atlanta, down by a point. ...25-24 Cincinnati. But Atlanta has the football at the 11-yard line. Leon Hall on the sideline for the Bengals. And he is limping around, may have a cramp. Matt Ryan rolling. Looking. Ryan throws. Caught. Right. Touchdown. What a patient quarterback. 11-yard touchdown. Are back in front. I love watching this kid's team.
And now the Falcons are going to go for 2 points.
Third touchdown of the day for Ryan.
He's going to put Maualuga in a bind. Does he stay with Roddy White or force the quarterback to throw it? He forces the quarterback to throw it and leaves Roddy White open. Maualuga had no choice. He had to do one or the other. If he stays with Roddy White, Matt Ryan runs the ball into the end zone.
And now Atlanta will try for two. leading 30-25. Ryan in the shotgun. With Tom. Backs up. Throws it.
Oh, caught again! Ronnie White! What a vertical!
Talk about superstars on the field today, folks. We've seen a number of them, including these two, Matt Ryan, Roddy White. 32-25, Dirty Birds. 32-25, Falcons reclaim the lead. Roddy White, 9 catches, 186 yards, 2 touchdowns. The team record is 210 by Roddy White last October 11th against San Francisco.
At the beginning of the game, we said, despite, as you see, Adam Jones had a collision with Eric Weems right at the beginning of that last two-point conversion, and he went down and stayed down. Here's the touchdown. As he comes out, you see Mauluga has to decide, does he leave White and go defend Ryan, or does he defend White and let Ryan run into the touchdown?
Jones being helped off the field. Returning a fumble for a touchdown in this game. Let's hope that he is okay as they sit him down next to Tank Johnson. I'll tell you, a cast of characters on this Bengals team this year. Tank Johnson, Adam Jones, Ocho Cinco, T.O. Just to name a few. 32-25. As the Falcons send it away. Scott brings it out of the end zone at the 10. Gets to the 20. Nice return as he gets to the 25-yard line before being stopped. A 24-yard return and the tackle made by Gartrell Johnson on special team. Wednesday on CBS, when the prosecution fights dirty, the defenders fight back. Jim Belushi and Jerry O'Connell star Wednesday only CBS. 12:56 to play, fourth quarter. It's starting to get warm inside the Georgia Dome. First down for Carson Palmer at the 25. Benson in the backfield. Here's Palmer to throw it over the middle. T.O. at the 25 goes backwards and is taken down. Curtis Lofton, the middle linebacker, first man to him, no gain.
This is just a small route over the middle, call it a zero route. And because it's zone coverage, he stops right over the football. If they'd have been man-man, he would have kept it going across the field, but did the right thing, stop, took the hit for it. Small game.
Second and 10 at the 25. Watch Shipley in the slot at the bottom. He's been terrific today. They hand it off. Benson. And Benson spins, dives, and gets to the 29. Lofton with the tackle again. It's a 4-yard gain. So that'll bring up third down and 6.
And the Cincinnati Bengals going to go no huddle like they have at times during this game. Gus, they've been the most effective when they've dropped Carson Palmer back and let him throw it. I think they should return to that.
T.O. at the top of your screen. Ocho Cinco at the bottom. Shipley in the slot at the bottom. First down. Very effective as Shipley on third and 6 gains 8. Brian Williams with the tackle.
Nice route by Shipley. He's going to go out, looks to the inside, and then comes right back to the line of scrimmage. It looks subtle, but it's really important. When he turns around to look for the football, he starts running back the direction he came from, and that's what got the separation, allowed the completion.
Shipley, six catches, 131 yards and a touchdown. First down at the 37. Benson to the 40, 44 and a half. As he picks up seven. Ryan Williams again with the tackle. Cincinnati with great rhythm on offense now, and everything turned around when they went to the no huddle.
Yeah, that really, really seems to do something to the Atlanta defense. They like the matchups. When they get their three wides on the field with Gresham at tight end and Benson in the backfield, that's exactly what the Cincinnati Bengals want.
Second down and three at the 44. Play fake. Palmer over the middle. Ocho Cinco, great catch at the 40, making the 38. And Chad Ocho Cinco stopped by Curtis Lofton, but he gains 17.
One of the things that happens here is when you go no huddle, your offensive line gets much, much more effective, particularly when you make first downs, because the defense can't substitute. Those big guys on the defensive line get too tired to rush the passer. They just start leaning on that offensive line, and Carson Palmer gets more and more and more time.
Nine catches, 100 yards for Ocho Cinco. Here's Palmer again. Pump fake. Up top. T.O. Down inside. No, they say he's out of bounds. Terrell Owens says, I had that football.
Well, it was a great pump fake. You saw the time that Carson Palmer had, and Owens just bites. And you see, catches it, turns, and his left foot came down on the line, and then he drops the ball after that. Watch, he catches it, right foot down, left foot on the line. He's out of bounds. Great call by the official.
Second down and 10 at the 39. Benson.
Puts the move right here on Lofton, and it just comes out. And then Lofton, trying to tackle him, bats the ball up in the air, and it's a huge break for Cincinnati that Williams doesn't just scoop this and go the distance. At least the Bengals defense has a chance.
So now Atlanta takes over at the Cincinnati 48. Turner running right, and Turner gets to the 43-yard line. Robert Gethers with the tackle. Remember, Benson almost fumbled it in the first half, Steve, that
on reception
would have resulted in a touchdown, but he caught a break. The Bengals caught a break, and the officials in the replay booth said that he did not have possession of the football.
You can read it on his face how upset he is.
Second and five to the 43. Turner. And Turner. Nice tackle. Spico stops him for a two-yard gain.
And as bad as that was for the Bengals, there's still over 8.5 minutes left in this game. Plenty of time. And it really, for the Atlanta Falcons, this is no time to get conservative. They've got to go like it's 0-0.
Third down, three at the 41. Falcons 4 of 9 on third down conversions. Ryan underneath, caught by Michael Jenkins. And a first down, Falcons. That's a gain of 11.
And that's enormous, because now they're in field goal range. And Michael Jenkins back in the lineup. You see how tall he is, hovering over the top of Leon Hall. Hasn't been much of a factor today because of the game Roddy White has had, but still, huge catch at a crucial time.
Snow. Snelling in the game. At tailback. First down and 10. Play fake. Ryan rolls. Looks. Backs up. And throws it out of bounds. Good coverage on that play by the Bengals.
Really good coverage. And I'll tell you, you want to know why they call Matt Ryan Matty Ice. It takes a lot of cool to not throw this ball away and give your guys a chance, then back away, and then dump this ball out of bounds with Gathers right in your face. I mean, that's
Ryan, far side, light with the catch, and he gets down the sideline. And they spot him out of bounds about the 21. Look at Trent. He tackle a 9-yard gain.
Yeah, and this is a quick throw, and this is a nice 9-yard run for Roddy White, extending almost to the first down marker.
Roddy White, 10 catches, 195 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Third down, 1 to the 21. Empty backfield for Ryan. Rolls to his left. Throws on the run. Wide out of bounds. At the 15. And that's a first down. On third and 1, they get 6.
And I'll tell you, if you want to see a receiver who is playing at the very peak of his abilities, Roddy White is the guy. They call his number. The Bengals know he's getting his number called, and they can't stop it.
First down at 10 at the 15, also a quarterback that's playing. Incredible football, Matt Ryan. The handoff, Snelling. And Snelling with some room. Gains 4 yards. Geno Atkins with the tackle.
This has been a part of the field during this game where the Falcons have really leaned on their running game to get them into the end zone, inside the 10-yard line. You look there. There it is. 201 so far. With a few minutes to go, he may get that.
Approaching the 6-minute mark of the fourth quarter. And he's down. Matt Ryan under a lot of pressure. Chris Redman, the backup quarterback, starts to get loose. And Matt Ryan is hurt.
Yeah, you'll watch. Here's the pressure. He pumped it. He wanted to get rid of it right there. Didn't. And he held on to it. And that's right to his low back.
Keith Rivers.
It was a clean hit. Head to the side. But it might be that the Falcons will take a timeout here and give Matt Ryan a chance to gather himself so he can stay in the game. Because right now, if he comes out, he has to leave the field unless there's a timeout.
And Atlanta with only 1 timeout remaining. So Ryan goes over to the sideline. And here comes Chris Redman. And the numbers for Matt Ryan, close to 300 yards, 3 touchdowns. So Chris Redman, former Baltimore Raven, comes in his 8th year out of Louisville, facing a 3rd down and 1. Atlanta 6 of 11 on 3rd down conversion. Looks like Ryan will just take off 1 play. Redman hands it off. Turner, first down and more.
Well, that's all you needed Redman to do. Let Matt Ryan walk off the field, catch his breath, get a drink, and come right back on. And the crowd appreciates it. And they're not clapping because of Redman's play. He did.
Big smile on Chris's face.
Chris knows he got the big cheer not for coming out of the game and playing well. He got the cheer because Matt Ryan is coming back onto the field.
First down and goal to the 3-yard line. Two tight ends. Turner around the corner. Turner. Touchdown.
Falcons have been so physical inside the Bengals 5-yard line today, and this is one more example of it.
Extra point up and good. Turner, 21 carries, 125 yards, 2 touchdowns. Cedric Vincent wishes he could have held on, because now the Falcons take a 39-25 lead. That shot kind of says it all, Steve, for the two running backs.
No question. Michael Turner feeling really good about the touchdown. Cedric Benson trying to get over the fact that he gave them the opportunity by fumbling it away.
Bernard Scott slips, and he'll bring it out of the end zone. And Scott tackled at the 14, and 18-yard return. Chris Owens with the tackle. Beautiful shot of Centennial Olympic Park here in Atlanta. And the hometown team has a big lead now, 39-25, as the Bengals will start from their own 14. Palmer throwing on first down. Underneath, and this is the tight end, Gresham. And he picks up 6 yards. First time. I think it's the second time we've called his name. 2 catches, 11 yards. There's an injured player.
Nicholas slow getting up. You gotta tip your hat to both these clubs. Atlanta Falcons are a good football team, one of the best in the NFC, certainly. Have their sights set on the playoffs, and rightfully so. The Cincinnati Bengals coming off a great year last year where they swept the AFC North, having trouble getting started today and looking, as we said, you know, flatlined in the first half of this game, and then turning it on and coming back and scoring 21 unanswered points in the third quarter, 22 unanswered points. Marvin Lewis,
take a look at what's at stake for Cincinnati. They're chasing Baltimore and Pittsburgh, and the Bengals lose this one, it makes it even tougher.
Absolutely.
Those two other teams are winning. Baltimore beating the Bills.
And if you look at the Atlanta Falcons, I mean, they've got a stretch of games coming up that is really, really tough. It doesn't get easy for them.
Cleveland Browns giving New Orleans all they can stand today. Second down and 4 at the 20. Outside, Gresham again. He goes out of bounds. Let's take a look at the schedule for the Atlanta Falcons. Tampa is up next after the bye. Baltimore, St. Louis playing much better. Green Bay, that is a murderous schedule coming up.
Tampa Bay just beating this same Cincinnati team a couple of weeks ago.
First down and 10 at the 26. Palmer over the middle. T.O. at the 30. Tackle from behind. Gets up to about the 33. 8-yard gain. Jonathan Babineau with the tackle. Terrell Owens, 9 catches, 88 yards. Palmer again. Underneath, and it's Scott. Lost the ball. They say it's a fumble, but it looks like he will be down.
Didn't hear a whistle.
5-yard gain as Christopher Owens makes the tackle. And now the NFC South standings. New Orleans and Tampa both losing. First down and 10 at the 38. Palmer down the sideline. Incomplete. Joe Cinco, the intended receiver.
Yes, you talk about what it's going to be like for Cincinnati and how important this game was. After this, they have Pittsburgh, Indianapolis. Then they'll get a game off with the Buffalo Bills, who are 0-5 today. Then they get the Jets and then the Saints. The Bengals are in a deep hole.
Palmer. Gresham again, the tight end, lost it, picked up. And that ball just bouncing right into the hands of Ocho Cinco.
Watches Gresham. We saw this play earlier be completed to Ocho Cinco. Yeah, they just got a lucky break.
First down at the 45. With running room gets close to the 30, and it takes us to the 2-minute warning. 39-25 Falcons. Tonight on 60 Minutes, how did a TV show about guys and cars and laughs become one of the most popular shows on the planet? Find out tonight on 60 Minutes, only CBS. First down and 10 at the 31 for the Bengals. Trailing 39-25. What a second half. To the sideline, Scott out of the backfield. Goes out of bounds. 1:54 remaining. 5-yard gain. So let's take a look. First quarter pretty even, 7-3. Second quarter, Atlanta pours it on. They score 17 points. So Cincinnati comes out in the third quarter and takes the lead with 22. And after that, Atlanta woke up, scores 15 points in the fourth. Cincinnati scoreless, and we have a 39-25 lead.
Streaky game.
Second down and 5 at the 26. Palmer. And he's sacked from behind. Great job by John Abraham. Second sack of the day for the Falcons.
Just took too long down the field for Carson Palmer to find an open guy. Abraham looking so fast, coming all the way deep, all the way around Smith. Not a good day for Andre Smith. First round draft pick last year out of Alabama, getting the start today.
Fifth sack of the season for Abraham. A loss of 7.
Talked to John Abraham on Friday. He was a pretty engaging guy. It was really fun to talk to him, really articulate. You can tell he's a veteran football player, been around the block once or twice. Then his lights are on. I mean, the guy's very intelligent, very well spoken, and he's a great football player. And trying to get back into double digit sacks this season.
Third down and 12 to the 33. Palmer steps up, fires into the flats, finds Scott. And Scott goes out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. With 1:39 to go, Mike Peterson giving chase.
Now watch. Ocho Cinco's going to come up, run to the post, then he's going to break this to the corner. He's going to come open, and Carson Palmer decided not to throw it in there and took the dump off, which got him down inside the 10-yard line. I think there are certain times when Carson Palmer would take that shot. At this point of the game, he decided not to because he wanted to get the yardage. We'll have to see if it works out, but that's a hard ball to let go down to that corner route.
First down and goal of the 8. Palmer pumping, fires in the end zone. Ocho Cinco there, touchdown.
You
think back around this game about all the things that have happened, the missed field goal at the end of the first half, two missed two-point conversions, and everything changes a little bit when you see all those points being thrown around on the conversion times, as you see the good catch in the back of the end zone by Ocho Cinco.
Mike Nugent in to attempt the extra point. The extra point is good. Ocho Cinco, 64 career receiving touchdowns, most in the history of the Cincinnati franchise. Carson Palmer today throwing for over 400 yards and three touchdowns. And this one isn't over yet. What's coming up here, Mark?
Well, a special teams nightmare. It's going to be an onside kick for the Bengals. Two timeouts, they can stop the clock with a minute and a half left. Obviously, if the Atlanta Falcons get this ball, with possess this ball after the kick and can get one first down, this game will be over.
Cincinnati with two timeouts left, Atlanta with one timeout left. So here comes the hands team. As you take a look, most receiving touchdowns. How about Isaac Curtis? Look cool.
A lot of touchdowns. Three great receivers right there. Now you can see here's Roddy White, who's not a special teams player, out to the edge. And on the far side, they've got Snelling, running back. Obviously, you see all these guys. Only one guy back deep. And the object is for your team to finish this play with the ball, no matter what. And it is a car wreck.
Mike Nugent. Let's see which way he decides to go. Wait a minute.
And now the Falcons got to look at their look, and then they call a timeout. So now they can call exactly what they think the Bengals are going to do. Keith Armstrong, the special teams coordinator for the Falcons, will gather his guys up. Now he's going to give them a sense of what they can expect. See there? He's drawing. That's where they were lined up a minute ago. Now, that's what he's going to have. All those lines, he's telling them what they're going to do. Pick a guy, knock him away from our guy with the ball. They're going to have to initiate contact. And the key thing is, you've got to, as the receiving team, the Atlanta Falcons have to attack the football. The Bengals cannot touch them until the ball goes 10 yards. But the Falcons are perfectly free to step closer than 10 yards to field it. And until they do, there can't be any contact. And the best thing you can do if you're a Falcon, if the ball's up in the air, is bat that thing clear out of bounds.
Teed up for Nugent. He goes that way. It's up. And Finneran grabs it. But a flag on the play. Ryan Finneran.
I think Cincinnati was offsides. The final small mistake.
Offside. Kicking team number 93. The 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down, Atlanta.
Michael Johnson.
Yeah, running through. And you see how crazy it can get down there.
So the Falcons out of timeouts. Cincinnati with two remaining. Turner in the backfield with Ovi Mahalan. Make that Snelling. Give it to Turner, and he's tackled immediately. Take Johnson. Coming up next, Tom Brady leads the Patriots out west to meet Phillip Rivers and the Chargers. For the Raiders, tackle the Broncos. Check your local listings.
Falcons have got to feel really good about the game they put together. You see their owner, Arthur Blank. But the Falcons really put together a great effort today. Now the Cincinnati Bengals banged back and got back into this game in the third quarter. But when the Falcons needed it, it seemed they always had it to give.
Second down at 15. Turner running straight ahead. Turner stopped by Dehani Jones. Cincinnati will call its final timeout with a minute and 22 remaining.
All right, so it'll bring up third down. After this next play, they won't be able to stop the clock, the Cincinnati Bengals, which will force the Falcons to punt the football, which means the Bengals will get it back with about maybe 30 seconds left on the clock or less.
Michael Turner, big day. 22 carries, 119 yards, and a couple of touchdowns. Ocho Cinco, much better second half. So far, 10 catches, 108. Cedric Benson, big fumble. Turner running. And he goes down to the 35. And the clock will continue to run.
And I think it'll almost get to the point where the Falcons would be happy to take a delay of game here, punt this football away, hopefully get it inside the 20, inside the 5 if they can. And of course the Bengals will do everything they can to stuff this punt, scoop it up and run for a touchdown. I mean, this is a time when you could really use a guy like Adam Jones back returning the punt. He walked off injured a little earlier.
Jones on the sideline.
And there indeed is the delay of game. 35 seconds left.
Seconds remaining, so Cincinnati will get another opportunity. Juan Cosby back deep. Gio putting his helmet on.
The block is on. There's no question you're going to try and block this punt. Cosby's going to try and field it or let it get into the end zone.
Caden. Darren Bennett. Aussie kick. Cosby inside the 5, a 33-yard punt.
Yeah, I don't know that I would fair catch that. It landed inside the 5 on the 2. I'd almost try and block the guys away from it, get a chance maybe to drip kick it into the end zone, have it bounce into the end zone. Cosby, no doubt doing what he was told, but usually the rule is you stand on the 10 and don't retreat, maybe on the 5 in this situation, but to drop back to your 3-yard line and field that kick, I don't think is the right thing to do. They're going to give it to him on the 4-yard line, which I think is charity.
So the Bengals are out of timeouts. 28 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter, down 39-32.
Three defensive linemen, two linebackers, and every DB on the roster.
Palmer steps up, throws over the middle. Would have given them some breathing room for sure.
The way this game has gone with the big plays and the people and the playmakers on both these teams, there's no way you can think this game is completely over.
Remember, no timeouts for Cincinnati. Second and 10. To the sideline. Caldwell can't get out of bounds. Cincinnati's got to hurry. 13 and counting.
That's a crusher.
Caldwell's got to get out of bounds. 5 seconds as they spike it.
That's a crusher.
So with 4 seconds remaining, Bengals will have to try.
Well, the only hope, and right here you'll see, Caldwell's just got to take this and get out of bounds to stop the clock right there. And Owens does a nice job. Chris Owens has really played a great game. He's in the game because Dante Robinson was injured, and Chris Owens has really stepped up to the plate.
Should be the final play of the game. Here's Carson Palmer.